Hello, I'm Mr. Arnija, a retired lecturer in rheumatology, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I want to add a small video on definition, you know, that how you can recognize whether the person you are speaking to has learned something or next to nothing. So it's very simple. And whenever you talk to people, ask them simple question. Now my brethren, you know, sometimes they want to speak to these Sikhs with turban and beard. So here is something for them, you know, that they should keep it in mind. In Sikhism, we have six Satgurus. Satgurus are called Christ in English. And four royal kings called Sache Patshah. Patshah means one who keep your honor intact. There is no guru in Sikhism. You know that most of the people will say Guru Nanak, Guru Har Gobind, Guru Gobind Singh. They are insulting them. And they have learned next to nothing. They might know the letters of the book, but not the spiritual meaning. Satguru or Christ Nanak to Satguru Arjan Dev Ji are five. And the sixth Satguru was Tegh Bahadur Ji. So they were six Satguru and four royal kings. The word Satguru Tegh Bahadur Ji, the word proclaimed by them is in the Sikh holy book called Ad-Granth. Ad-Granth has the message of these six only, nobody else. Most of the six, and also, sorry, this Bhagat, you know, Bhakti Kabir, Namdev, and all those Bhagat, you know. And you remember that these Khatris, who are the standing people, they have removed the saying of some Bhagat. Bhakti Meera, Meera Devi, her slokas have been taken off, you know. They have cleaned about 250 pages from the holy book, whitewashed. So what you get is a corrupted version in the Sikh temples. Most of the Sikhs do not know this difference, and you should tell them. Guru stands for a rabbi or a pandit, a moral teacher. Mother, father, and pandit are the moral teachers. Mother gave you social, father economical, pandit gave you political education. Pandit or rabbi deals with sins. They have scripture, transgression against the moral law is sins. Whilst the one who preaches gospel to mind is called a Satguru. Sat is his word. Gur means logical reasoning. Satguru stands for a person who is capable of logical reasoning. Such people are called Gurmukhs. Gur stands for logical reasoning, and Mukh stands for mouth. Gurmukhs always speak logically. Sikh stands to the sermon. Sikhs stand to the sermon on the mount. In that, if somebody hits you on one cheek, present the other. So this Sikh is a miscontinuation of Christianity, and that's what I'm stressing this one, so that people should know. Should present the other cheek to awaken his conscience. You hit him at the conscience, you know, not physically. As Jesus did when someone slapped him for not answering to their chief temple priest. Jesus asked the person who struck him, "For what wrong have you, what wrong have I done that you have slapped me?" So the person could not answer, you know. He had no conscience. The guy was the stooge of the temple high priest. A person with no conscience will hit you harder. So if a person has no conscience, you know, and you tell him why you hit me, then he will hit you harder to show you why he hit it. He has no conscience. Next time, but most people have conscience. And religion is for the people who have conscience, for them only. Sons of Satan, the tares, have no conscience. And that you can see in the Jewish people bundled up in Israel. They are getting bundled up in Israel for the final burning. So you can see what type of conscience they have, you know. That will give you an idea of the sons of Satan. Then there are four royal kings called Sache Pasha, and they are of the highest order. You have moral teacher, which we call Guru. Then you have spiritual preacher, which we call Satguru. Satguru is a preacher, he is not a teacher. Teacher is teaching scriptures. A woman cannot teach, but she can preach gospel. Preaching is like a sower, his word. Those who are predestined, they get it. You can't put it through their mouth. So the royal king, Sache Pasha, is of the highest order. So they don't bend before secular kings. If someone addresses Satguru Nanak Devi as Guru, the rabbi, then he is degraded. Then he is degrading. He is degrading Satguru Nanak Devji, degrading him to the level of rabbi or pandit, the moral teacher. But his word is for your mind, man, not for your body. So the mind is abstract. This is not abstract, this is concrete. It is abstract that only the men of spirit can understand. His word is only for men of spirit. Holy Spirit with small s is common sense, our spirit of man. Whilst Holy Spirit with capital S, the wage or gratitude, the 12 laborers bestowed by the grace of our Father God, is extraordinary sense, which is supernatural sense. So this is body is natural, and those who are of a mind, they are supernatural. So they have the over above nature, you know, they can control nature. As Jesus calmed the storm, healed the sick, and made the dead alive. So if someone addresses royal king Sache Pasha Gobind Singh Ji as a guru, he is highly degrading him. And such a person has no knowledge of Sikhism. That is why Christ Thomas stressed that one in a thousand and two in 10,000 will understand gospel. And Christ Nanak, in the form of Christ Tegh Bahadur Ji, the last Christ on earth, stressed that one in a million will understand his word called Bani. So religion is not far, is not that cheap, is not that cheap as most people think. Lucky are the ones who are of spirit called Surti, Surti in Punjabi, which means the same thing as Holy Spirit. So this is a short introduction. And then most of the other things you can learn later on, because if you do not know the basic, then without basic you cannot understand gospel. And if you go on my website, you will find this chart which gives you a deeper sense. This is called five. Why there were five spiritual temptations, evil temptation, why they were five, which the Samaritan woman had the husbands, five husbands. These were the five husbands, which are Kaam, then you have Krodh, Lobh, Moh and Hankar. These are the five husbands of the Samaritan woman, which she had overpowered. They had controlled them. So she was Saint Fortuna, but the light of Christ Jesus was suppressed by the Messianic Jews. Light came among his own, but they loved darkness, so they killed light. Jesus was killed by the Jews, not by Pilate. They are accusing Pilate for nothing, because Pilate washed his hand under sun. Sun means God, our Father God. He washed his hand under sun that have nothing to do with the blood of this innocent man. So in the Bible they have put down he died under Pilate, and all that is corruption, you know. So most of the sensible people know what is the truth. So we should stick to that one. Our Father God blesses you.